Department of Periodontics and Preventive Dentistry, Manav Rachna Dental College. Today I'll be speaking about space maintainers. Space maintainers is a preventive tool used to prevent malocclusion in permanent dentition. We all know that primary teeth play a very important role in the life of a child. Okay, they help the child to chew properly, that is to provide the child with proper nutrition, help the child to speak properly, to look good and have a good feeling. And they also help to guide the underlying permanent tooth into proper position in the dental arch. Now, for some reason, if the primary tooth is lost prematurely, let's say because of some injury or because of untreated dental caries, a space is created in the dental arch. Now, this space could lead to the neighboring teeth getting migrated, or they can tilt into this space, causing malalignment. So this space must be preserved, and that is the reason why we give a space maintainer. Now, space maintainer is basically an appliance which is given to preserve the space which is created by premature loss of a primary tooth, and helps in the proper eruption of the underlying permanent tooth. Now, coming to the indications for giving a space maintainer. Space maintainer should be given if the root of the underlying permanent tooth is less than one-third developed. We all know that the tooth starts erupting once one-third of its root is developed. So if it is less than one-third developed, we give a space maintainer. We give a space maintainer if more than 2 mm of bone overlies the erupting permanent tooth. The underlying permanent tooth takes around 3 to 4 months to erupt through 1 mm of bone. A space maintainer should also be given if functions are to be preserved. Like, loss of incisors can lead to loss of, can affect the speech of a child. Loss of molars can affect the mastication. So if we want to preserve these functions, we give a space maintainer. The space maintainer that we give must have some requisites, must fulfill some requisites, like it must be rigid to bear the functional forces. It should be biocompatible with the soft tissues. It should not irritate the soft tissues. It should not hamper the growth. It should not come in the way of eruption of the underlying permanent tooth. It should be easy to clean and maintain. And it should be passive. It should not apply any force on the neighboring tooth or bone. We have many types of space maintainers. We can have removable space maintainers, fixed space maintainers, functional space maintainer, non-functional space maintainer, active and passive space maintainers. Coming to fixed space maintainers. Fixed space maintainers are those which can which we attach onto the adjacent teeth so that the patient and the caregiver cannot remove it. Now, the advantages of a fixed space maintainer are that we can give it to uncooperative patients because they cannot remove it. Because we band the tooth, there is no tooth preparation which is required. It does not hamper the jaw growth. It does not affect the eruption of the underlying permanent tooth. However, the disadvantages are that whenever we band a tooth, it becomes more prone to decalcification and caries. And also, it does not prevent the supraeruption of the opposing tooth. Now, there are various fixed space maintainers that we use, the most common one being the band and loop space maintainer. The band and loop space maintainer is given if we have the loss, unilateral loss of a primary molar, or a bilateral loss of a single primary molar. Now, coming to the lingual arch space maintainer, this space maintainer is given in the mandibular arch. It is indicated if we have loss of multiple primary molars, but it is important to remember that this space maintainer is given only once the permanent incisors erupt. We cannot give it when the primary incisors are there, because the primary incisors have the permanent incisor tooth bud lingual to it, and if we give it at that stage, it is going to hamper the eruption of the permanent incisors. The next space maintainer is the NANS palatal arch space maintainer. This is given in the maxillary arch. In case of bilateral loss of primary molars, it has an acrylic button on the rugae area, which helps in maintaining the stability of the dental arch. Next is the transpalatal arch space maintainer. This is given in case there is a unilateral loss of primary molars. It is very important that one side of the dental arch is intact when we give this space maintainer. The distal shoe space maintainer is given if we have loss of the primary second molar before the eruption of the permanent first molar. Now in this case, this is the only option that we have. The permanent first molar erupts at around 6 to 7 years of age. So if we lose the primary second molar before this age, we need to give the distal shoe space maintainer. It is also known as the intraalveolar space maintainer or the Willits appliance. In case we don't want to give a fixed space maintainer, we can go in for a removable space maintainer, which is given if the patient is cooperative. It's basically an acrylic partial denture that goes into the space which is created. In case there's only an acrylic plate that goes into the space which is created by the premature loss of the primary tooth, it is known as a non-functional removable space maintainer. But if we put an artificial tooth, then it becomes a functional removable space maintainer. We have a number of space maintainers from which we can decide which to give, but we must remember that the best space maintainer is the primary tooth, and all efforts must be done to maintain the primary tooth in the dental arch. In case you have any queries, you can reach me at my email ID, that is shwetasood.mrdc@mrei.ac.in.